Robert Sentongo restored the tax collector's lead, but the home side once again found the back of the net through Fred Kalanzi. For the former champion Zoo's coach expressed discontent with his defense.
Paraka de tu FC kugoli msanfu kuwelele, eh? Nesa uli kodi endale yeti.
Skip Tali looking for Senkatuka. And now Robert Sentongo, away goes Robert Sentongo. It's Robert Sentongo! Never disappoints when he gets the ball in there, Robert Sentongo. Well, everybody of Proline went forward, Robert Sentongo remained behind. And when the chance came, Robert sinks it in. Proline 0, KCC 1.
Making the ball pass in between the legs of the keeper, that is something that players want normally to do. A very good goal scored by Mujibox would have been a red card in future.
Oh, there you go, it's another goal. This into a good goal, and look at the dancing of this.
Sanyi fokuda naye twakuwa kibi nsanze ligi kesera ikigiri naye tugenda geza ko kulabanga twangule cha tuende kesi twabo besura tusobule kwanga twala ligi naye nga yuka kungunjeka kasatu yana jitwala kwa hiyo achaliwo chance sipa bi naye nduza kasokede samba vipa yakango bako mulundi obagumu atimba ina mukisantero bate benyo iranja ko experience jenina tulabenga tusobola ba wangulu na kulwenga
Thank you. And of course, the Kilimanjaro Stars are on the left side of your picture in blue, green and black. The national colors, very, very pretty squad, I should say. So then this is the starting 11 for Tanzania. Juma Kaseja does contain and retain his position in between the sticks. Erasto Nyoni, Mufara Amil Mrisho, and of course the legs of Kevin Jordan and Shomari Kapombe will be making sure they can keep a clean sheet here today. Mrisho Ngasa and John Boko have scored 5 goals apiece, and they'll be looking for more goals in today's match, as Hamza Mwonge does maintain his position in goal as well. Dennis Iguma, Godfrey Walusimbi, Isaac Isinde and Henry Kalonji in defense. They're going to cringe today without Emmanuel, without their lead striker, that is Brian Omony, will be hoping to pick maximum points in this one. Ali Chimera and Hamis Kiza, Saidi Chayne on the bench. Tanzania will be looking at Simon Musuva and Yahaya Singano. Brilliant atmosphere here for a football game. And now we'll go for the national anthems. Up front, the flag does stay down. It's goalkeeper against Amis Diego Kizza Sentongo! And the Uganda Cranes have the goal they have been looking for. The cushion has finally arrived. Robert Sentongo, top scorer in the Bell Ugandan Super League, has lived up his expectation and starting in a big game like this one. The Uganda Cranes have now 2 goals. Big strike from a small man from the big occasion. Fans will celebrate because now they have a chance. That is a very important goal.
Yeah, the high line backfires. The Cranes refuse to fall into the offside trap. Amis Kiza goes wide. I've never seen him provide like this. Usually he is the finisher, but what an assist this is. Sentongo says thank you very much, slams that into an open net. He celebrates. Bobby Williams, and he knows the importance of having a cushion goal.
It is Tanzania 0, Uganda 2. But we shall keep insisting. That is as it stands, as Robert Sentongo now breaks into the box, keeps his composure here. He doesn't seem to be excited.
Football fans and players will tell you that's a lot of time, and that is a high boot coming in Robert Sentongo.
Yeah, why would the Tanzania players go into the referee's face like that? That is clearly a terrible, terrible boot in Sentongo's chest. Is that an attempt to win the ball? Really? Sentongo is the man who was taken out. And he's got up. He's been in the faces of these Tanzanian players and he's irritated the defenders badly. Kevin Jordan and Shomari Kapombe have not been happy at all with the little flea.
Oh, the little flea, you do call him. Suddenly having a good game at the moment. Scored a goal as well.
And this is what we are talking about. This is Athman Idi and Kevin Jordan. That is a high boot, man.
How can that be a challenge going for the ball? And how can the Tanzanian players have any complaints about that? It should be sent off. As simple as that.
Oh. Mohamed El Fadir has let this one go.
And instead does suggest a Uganda Cranes should benefit from the free kick.
So a couple of options for the Cranes. One of those is a Joseph Ochaya. As he steps forward quickly against Kaseja, he does steal it, and the Cranes make it 3. The Uganda Cranes with Robert Sentongo. They have not only scored 3, but Sentongo has scored his 2nd, and the fans will join the players in dancing and celebrating here. This game is turning out to be fully one-sided. Just when you thought Tanzania were out of their blocks, the Uganda Cranes have made it 3. Juma Kaseja will not be very happy with how he handles the ball. And that man did give to Uganda the free kick, and now he's made it 3. This is very crucial for Uganda now.
Yeah,
Oloya, this time Ochaya leaves it to Oloya. He bends it over Kasete, does not get a hold of it. Sentongo is the poacher. He's in there. He gets an assist. It's from the defender and he slams it into the net for his fourth of the tournament. He's fast closing in on Richard Ngasa and John Boko. They've got five. They're in this game. They're not close to scoring. The goalkeepers don't concede at the near post. Try telling Okui that. Second goal, Robert Sentongo, fed by his partner, Diego Hamis Kiza. And then the third one, the goalkeeper, spilling this, and Sentongo helping himself to a second. His fourth of the tournament puts him third in the top scorers table, just behind Mauricio Ngasa.
Uganda coming forward now. This is a shot. Oh, and they've scored.
Well,
they scored.
There. Uganda get that goal. Well, you can only control the game for so long.
It's a really soft goal.
Well, what a playback, and the new substitute, he knows very well. Robert Sentongo, who has just come in, gets the first goal for Uganda. And well, you see the positioning of the goalkeeper, Wilson Oboro. He lost his positioning in goal, and it was a feeble shot, really, Taiwo. It was nothing that looked like it was going to give Oboro any problem in goal.